live bands, let's start to get loud in here, folks. I don't think you heard me, Prince George. It's time to make some noise. Before we get to the national anthem, we have a special presentation for tonight's game. At this time, we'd like to recognize our graduating players. Each of these players made a lasting impact to our team through their time and commitment to the program, their leadership, mentorship, and dedication, and we can't wait to see where they go next in their careers. Once a Kodiak, always a Kodiak. Our graduating players are, starting from Pickering, Ontario, number 3, Aiden Simpson. From Prince George, number 4, Andrew Johnson. From Medicine Hat, Alberta, number 8, Caden Wagner. Number 14, Matt Stackhouse. Coming all the way from Calgary, Alberta, number 15, Zane Kaziba. From right here in Prince George, number 40, Brandon Reed. Saskatchewan, number 43, Riley Ahmed. From Fort McKay, Alberta, number 44, Seth Berlin. And finally, from Calgary, Alberta, number 72, let's hear it for Adam Kalinla. Yes. at this time, we ask you to rise and remove your hats for the singing of tonight's national anthem, sung by Mr. Damian Dorster. Take it away, Damian.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Fans, it's time for
tonight's coin toss.
The Kodiaks will receive the ball first, folks.
Okay, we can go.
This kickoff is brought to you by the PFL Insurance, proud supporter of Prince George Creek.
Hello, Kodiaks fans, and welcome back to Massage Place Stadium, whether that's tuning in on 99.3 or Rewind Radio, or if you happen to be catching the live stream on DCXETV.com or Telescope Cable Channel 1981. Thank you so much for tuning in, whether you are a Kodiaks fan, whether you're a Rams fan, or just a fan of BCFC football. We're about to get this game underway. The Langley Rams will be kicking the ball off to the Prince George Kodiaks. The Rams donning their white jerseys with blue trim. Meanwhile, the Prince George Kodiaks set to receive. They'll be in their black uniforms with gold trim. 15 minutes up on the clock to get this game started. The crowd's here, and we're ready for some Saturday night football here in Prince George. And here we go, the Rams kicking the ball away right down the middle. Aiden Simpson makes the return, and he tries to find a lane. Gets a few yards upfield, and before getting brought down by number 20, Isaiah Cooper of the Rams.
First down, Prince George.
The Prince George Kodiaks offense, the first time on the field for tonight. They'll get this series underway, led by number 4, Andrew Johnson. A change at quarterback as Sam Saban and Quinn Newcomb not in the lineup for tonight's game. It'll be Andrew Johnson trying to lead this offense here tonight. And he'll start in the shotgun, handing it off to Xander Shane. He gets wrapped up and brought down immediately behind the line of scrimmage.
Number 18, Xander Shane on the rush for Prince George.
Number 19 coming up with the tackle. That's Dawson Morin.
It'll be second down and 13 for the
Second and 13 for the Kodiaks. Ball spotted between the hash marks. The ball being spotted at about the 36-yard line. Trips left set for the Kodiaks here to the far side of the field. Andrew Johnson drops back, looks to throw, connects with Caden Wagner. And that'll be...
pass block by number 8, Caden Wagner.
A gain of maybe 5 or 6 yards, not enough to pick up the first down. That'll bring out the punt team. So a two and out here for PG. At Stackhouse to punt this ball away. He'll position himself about the 30-yard line, catches, kicks it up, and that gets blocked. And the return here by the Rams, trying to find the sideline, is number 27, and he'll try to find the way into the end zone, but gets wrapped up and brought down at the 5-yard line. And a scrum here between, I believe that's Coulter Cannon and number 3.
Blocked by the Langley Rams.
From the Langley Rams, flags being thrown, the helmet of number 3 of the Rams.
It will be first and goal from Langley. There is a flag on the play, folks.
Off his head as he makes his way back to the sideline. The officials meeting here. Looks like the penalty is going against the Rams. So a blocked punt to start this game very early here in the opening quarter. A solid return takes it down to the 5-yard line. However, a penalty going against the Rams will move the ball back and take away what would have been that first and goal situation. Instead, they'll still have solid field position to get this drive underway. The ball being spotted at the Prince George 25-yard line.
Penalty is on the way, folks. It is first down at the 25 for the Rams.
Rams offense led by number 11, Trey Jones. Ball spotted on the near side. Ashmar trips right. They'll take the snap, hands it off to number 22. He's trying to find his way to the sideline. And he'll get popped and then get forced out of bounds.
Number 22, Cairo Hassan on the carry for the Rams.
Number 22, Cairo Hassan with the
some support
carry on that play.
It's not a race to noise right now.
Collision between him and number 3, Aiden Simpson. Pick up about 5 yards on the play, takes it down to the 20. Break the huddle. And they'll set up once again. Trips right to the far side. Single back to the right side of Trey Jones. Jones takes the snap, looks over the middle, looks for the end zone, and that gets picked off by Aiden Simpson, his first of the season. And that gets the crowd into this one and forces a turnover. Trey Jones throws his third interception of the season as Aiden Simpson jumps right in front of that and takes it away. Prince George Kodiak's offense comes back out on the field. They'll have this drive starting at the 20-yard line. Interception coming inside the end zone, so it will be a touchback. Brings the ball out to the 20, and Andrew Johnson looks to get this offensive drive underway. Some pressure coming off the far side. Tries to pass it, but it gets deflected, and that will fall incomplete. It'll bring up second down.
It'll be second down for Prince George.
It'll be second and 10. Still with the ball spotted at the 20-yard line. Kodiak's come out of the huddle and he trips left set. Three receivers to the far side of the field. Xander Shane comes into motion, goes off tackle. Ball gets snapped. Andrew Johnson running and he'll throw a pick. And that forced fumble here. And Andrew Johnson looked like he had contact as it skipped out of bounds. Jerome Erickson forces the fumble on the return, and Andrew Johnson trying to jump onto it to get the ball right back. Turnover mayhem here early on between the Kodiaks and the Rams. And it is being awarded to the Kodiaks. So solid effort there by Jerome Erickson to force the fumble. Andrew Johnson getting his hands on the bouncing ball before it skipped out of bounds. That gets the ball back for Prince George.
Fans, we have an interception followed by a fumble recovered by the
and that will be
Kodiak.
First down for the Kodiaks with the change in possession during the play.
It'll
give them a first down from the 5-yard line. Andrew Johnson hands it off. Xander Shane tries to rush, but he gets hauled down by the tail of his jersey.
Number 18, Xander Shane.
Loss of about 3 yards. Was unable almost immediately as soon as he got the exchange from the quarterback, was being met by number 90 of the Rams. Number 90, Malik Washington, defensive lineman, interior lineman, I will say. 11:30 remaining here in the opening quarter. Kodiak's pinned up tight against their goal line. Andrew Johnson in the pistol inside the end zone. Andrew Johnson, he'll look to run, tries to find a lane, and gets wrapped up, brought down hard by number 4 of the Rams. Sean Cullen.
Andrew Johnson, with the
Andrew Johnson calling his own number. It looked like it was a passing play initially, but then tried to make something. But as a result, unable to get the yardage necessary to pick up a first down. And bring up third down. Inside the first 5 minutes of the opening quarter, we've had 3 turnovers. We've seen an interception by Trey Jones, then that was followed up by an interception from Andrew Johnson, but then that same play, a forced fumble by Jerome Erickson during that interception return, giving the Kodiaks the ball back. That last play, the Kodiaks conceding a safety on third down to give the Rams the first points of tonight's game as the Langley Rams find themselves ahead 2-0. Offense will now take to the field and start this drive at the 30-yard line.
And you know what that means? It's time to make some noise for our defense. Let's go out for George!
starts this drive on the far hash mark. As Trey Jones calls his name, looks to hand it off, immediately gets wrapped up in the backfield. Jason Pratt coming up with the tackle for the loss. As that was a wall of Kodiaks coming right through the offensive line. That'll be a loss of 3 yards on the play, bringing up second and 13. Drops back, settles in the pocket. He'll try to call his own number. He'll tuck it away and gets wrapped up by Pratt again. From behind, Jason Pratt flexing his muscles early here in the first quarter. And Trey Jones is down on the turf after that play. And the training staff for the Rams will come out onto the field. We'll take a moment, step away. We'll take a quick break. More Kodiaks football coming up. Okay. I'm going to take the opportunity. All right, we can go back. Welcome back, Trey Jones. Appeared to be injured on that previous play after getting wrapped up by Jason Pratt. And Trey Jones able to run off the field under his own weight. So that's a positive sign here. Bring it up third down. Near punt here. And the line drive skips to Aiden Simpson. And Simpson will look to return here. He'll get wrapped up, brought down just past the 35-yard line. He may have got out to the 36-yard line. Kodiak's offense comes back out onto the field, this being their third offensive drive of the quarter. There appears to be another injured Ram here on the play. Number, I think that's 21, it looks like. Could be 27. But he's quick to get off of the field. Actually, I was wrong on both parts. Number 37, rather. That's Thomas Wiggin getting assisted off of the field here. Cale Galley in at quarterback. He'll sweep it to Omar Martin. Martin plunging, moving the pile. A jet sweep play there with Omar Martin, usually in the backfield, but coming in from the slot receiver position for a jet sweep.
Second down and short for Prince George.
Gain about 6 yards on the play. Cale Galley, usually lining up as a wide receiver for the Kodiaks, is in at quarterback for Prince George. The 6'7" receiver now in at the pivot. We've got two backs in the backfield. Xander Shane and Omar Martin. Martin motions out. Here's a near completion there. Cale Galley looking for Jerome Erickson, but Erickson heard footsteps and said that falls incomplete. Would have been a massive hit had Erickson decided to try to put his body in front of that one, as there was a Langley Ram player flying down the field in pursuit. Instead, it will bring up third down. At Stackhouse, back to punt this ball away. Last one being blocked by the Rams. That marks back-to-back weeks that Prince George has had a punt blocked. Last week, the Rams returned that one for a touchdown. And a sure whether that was a design trick play there or whether it was just a bad snap from the long snapper, but Holter Cannon trying to scoop up the ball and come up with the yardage required for a first down, but instead gets met by the rush from the Langley Rams. In the backfield, Rams will take over on offense. Inside the Prince George end of the field, ball spotted at the 38-yard line, far side hash mark. Trey Jones back in the lineup. And here's a jet sweep, number 84, trying to find the sideline, gets wrapped up again. Jason Pratt, early on, comes up with his third tackle of the night. He chases down number 84. Nato Tedeschi of the Rams. There'll be a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11. Kevin 20 remaining here in the opening quarter. Rams lining up. Trips right. Three receivers to the far side of the field. Single back to the left of Trey Jones. There's some pressure coming from the Kodiaks. Jones looking deep, and that gets hauled in. A big catch is in double coverage, but a big catch there by Isaiah Edwards, top receiver for the Rams. Looked like Holter Cannon and Shannon Donovan were in coverage, but unable to get a mitt on the ball. Here's the Rams now, ball spotted, 9-yard line. It'll be first and goal. Jones in the shotgun, trips left. We'll hand off to Hassan. Hassan gets wrapped up from behind and hauled down. A big play there. That's Caden Crowe coming up with another tackle for a loss. This defense is not kidding around.
We gotta keep this energy going, Prince George. It's 7-12.
Second and 12. Trips left formation here for the Rams. Jones will take the snap. He'll draw back. He'll roll left. He's getting chased by the pressure. He'll look to pass, looking for the end zone. Touchdown! Number 81 of the Rams comes up with the scoring play. Isaiah Anderson, back-to-back weeks with touchdowns as he opened the scoring last week down in Langley, and he'll get the opening touchdown here to add to the Rams' already existing lead. Good patience there by Jones as the pocket quickly collapsed, rolled left, and was simply just waiting for his receiver to find some space. And with the convert, it puts the Rams ahead 9-0. We'll take a moment, take a quick break. More Kodiaks football coming up.
Our offense has the only team that knows about long drives. Driving Force is your go-to fleet management and transportation solution across Canada. Proud supporter of your Prince George Kodiaks.
Just a 30 and a bumper. Welcome back. Langley Rams making it 9-0 after a receiving touchdown to Isaiah Anderson. Here's a bit of a collision on the return. Taman Pittick comes up with the return and gets the ball up to the 43-yard line. A collision there between Aiden Simpson and Pittick. Simpson blocks off the field. And the Kodiaks offense going to find their first points here tonight. Cale Cowley in at quarterback. He'll have Xander Shane lined up behind him. time count violation going against the Kodiaks. Looked like there may have been some confusion from Cowley as he was trying to direct the offense. That will draw a delay of game penalty. Actually, the Kodiaks calling a timeout just in time as the official will pick up the flag. Kodiaks get bailed out by their coaching staff to avoid that penalty. The remain first and 10. Trips left formation, three receivers to the far side, two to the near side. Cowley drops back, some pressure coming up. Going over the middle, trying to connect with Aiden Lewis, but that will fall incomplete. As that will bring up second and 10. Lots of traffic over the middle there. Kodiaks huddle up. 4:57 remaining here in the opening quarter. Kodiaks break the huddle. Similar formation. Three receivers to the far side, two to the near side. Jerome Erickson will motion over. Cowley over to Erickson. Erickson tries to avoid. He'll break a few tackles, stay up on his feet, and he'll gain about 8 yards on the play before being forced out of bounds, and that draws a roll from the crowd. He'll bring up third down.
It's third and short for
Unsure. Not sure if the Kodiaks, it looks like the Kodiaks are bringing out their punt team, so quite the big play there from Erickson, shaking up three tackles, it looked like early on, just slipping out from under them. Only was able to pick up 9 of the 10 yards required for a first down. And there's a injured Ram down on the field. Not sure the jersey number, as the medical staff tend to the Langley player. Currently, the Prince George Kodiaks do have what appears to be their punt team out on the field. With number 12 for the Rams, Ryan Gosen, back to return this punt. He's lining up about the 15-yard line. Staff still tending to the injured Langley Rams, so we'll take a moment. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Prince George Kodiaks lining up third down. Some adjustments in the backfield. Looked like the Kodiaks were trying to go short yardage. It looked like there was movement. And they pulled Walker Cannon celebrating as he was able to successfully draw the Langley Rams offside on the play to give the Kodiaks the yardage required to get a first down. And the Kodiaks offense back out onto the field with 4:15 remaining in the opening quarter. Dale Galley breaks the huddle. Single back in the backfield. Three receivers to the far side. Galley in the pistol. Hands off, fumble on the exchange. Xander Shane looks like he may have pounced back onto it and may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. So a lucky bounce there for the Kodiaks as Shane was able to get back onto the ball.
Xander Shane recovered by Prince George.
And retained possession for Prince
George.
Second
down for the Kodiaks.
The second and 10. Rams lining up. We've got the lone safety here. Cowley drops back, looks to the near side, tries to connect to Caden Wagner, but that'll fall incomplete.
Incomplete. Third down for George.
And that will bring up third down. So out comes the punt team. This being third and 10, so do not imagine there being a trick play up the sleeve for Prince George here. As Ryan Gosen will anticipate the punt from Matt Stackhouse down on the Langley 10-yard line. Ball gets snapped, gets punted. Spiraling punt here. Gosen gets to it. He'll look to return. He tries to beeline it for the far sideline. Nick Tremblay tries to cut him off, but Gosen stays up on his feet, and he'll get wrapped up by Wagner, not before he returns it to about the 29-yard line.
There
is a flag though on the near sideline that looks like it'll be going against the Rams. So illegal block against the Rams will push them back, taking away the return of Gosen. Start this one at the 10-yard line. So exactly where Gosen originally was lined up to return the punt before the snap is where the Rams will get this drive underway. The 2:55 remaining here in the opening quarter. Trey Jones breaks the huddle. Three receivers to the near side. One back in the backfield. Believe that Hassan. Now hand off. Actually, that's Bruce Jones. Jones trying to carry the ball, gains a few yards. A flag in the backfield. Looks like the penalty going against the Rams. Maybe a hold going against Langley. And that'll push the Rams even further back. .36 on the clock here in the first quarter.
It'll be second down and 15 for the Rams. Let's get it on the top, Prince George.
Trey Jones right on the goal line. He lines up in the pistol. And here. A keeper actually by Jones. Jones tries to plunge forward. He'll still come up short of the original line of scrimmage. And he'll be able to pick up about 4 yards on the play.
Work out for Langley, Prince George.
He is second and just over 10 yards. 10 and a bit. Jones takes the snap. He'll hand it off. He gets wrapped up and brought down. This defense standing tall, Jason Pratt and Caden Crow. Stuffing the run on that. Brings up third down. Langley Rams pinned up against their own goal line. Punter is inside the end zone. We'll see if they will concede the safety or whether they'll try to punt it away, and they will try to punt it away. A spiraling kick here back to Aiden Simpson. Simpson makes the reception at the 55-yard line. He'll return it and gets forced out of bounds just in front of the Kodiak sideline. Kodiak's offense will come out onto the field with solid field position here, starting this drive. It looks to be the Langley 42-yard line. Ball gets spotted on the far side hash mark. Kodiak's break the huddle. Cale Galley lines up in front of the running back, Omar Martin. Strong side to the near side. Hand off to Omar Martin. He'll plunge forward right into a wall of
number 7, Omar L. Martin on the carry.
Defensive players and traffic for Langley. We find ourselves inside the final minute here in the first quarter. We'll bring up 2nd and 10. Was able to get back to the line of scrimmage. Snap, he'll drop back, looking deep, Aiden Lewis, and that slips right through the hands of Lewis as he was wide open.
Pass is incomplete. It's third down for Prince George.
Unfortunate mishap there by the Kodiak's receivers. Looked like he had made the adjustment. Traffic was going one way. Had he made the reception, it was open real estate in front of him. Instead, it brings up 3rd and 10. Punt team here at Stackhouse. Takes this ball, snap, kicks it away. It'll come up short of reaching the goal line. And Gosen tries to make the return before getting forced out of bounds. And he has to leap over one of the sideline pad signs. There's two flags hovering around the 10-yard line. Seconds on the clock. Looks like it's going against the Rams. A holding penalty going against Langley. It'll be first down for the Rams. 2.7 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Probably good enough to get one play in.
The penalty is a holding call.
The end of the quarter and the game's done. Goal line. He'll take the snap, he'll hand it off. That gets wrapped up. Bruce Jones gets wrapped up by the entire Kodiak's defense as they all just mob around him. He's able to push the pile forward for a few yards.
Good for 5 yards. It'll be second down for the Rams,
That'll bring an end to the quarter.
Fans,
Langley Rams lead the Kodiaks 9-0. More Kodiaks football coming up.
You know what to do when the song comes on. I want to hear every single person.
Welcome back. We're inside the break between quarters as we get ready to get the second quarter underway. Sweet Caroline coming on the PA here at Massage Place Stadium. And some delay here from the officials to get this quarter underway, which definitely caused some disappointment, or disappointing roars, I would say, from the crowd as it interrupted the playing of Sweet Caroline, a sports staple. I would fully anticipate we'll probably be trying to get that in at some point through the duration of the game, just to make sure we get that crowd involvement here tonight. But instead, still further delay from the officials as they try to coordinate the line markers. Looks like we're about ready to get this quarter underway. Second quarter action here in Prince George. Rams on offense. Jones takes the snap, drops back. Some pressure coming from the near side, and he'll connect to number two. Terrell Jones makes some wave past the defender before getting wrapped up by Aiden Simpson.
Number two, Terrell Jones with the reception for Lane Lee. That's good for a first down for the Rams. Fans, it's too quiet in here. We're on defense. If we need some help, let's get rowdy, Prince George.
First and 10 here for the Rams. Jones drops back, looks over the middle. He'll connect to Edwards. He'll slip past a few tackles before getting brought down to the field by number 45 of the Kodiaks. That's Joseph Bertrand.
Number 81, Isaiah Anderson on the catch for Langley. But it's still a second down, fans.
That brings up second and looks to be about 1.5 yards.
Let's see what you got, it, fans. Come on your defense, Prince George.
Jones. He'll hand it off. Here's Jones. Trey Jones to Bruce Jones. They'll gain a few yards and gets enough for the first down. Drops back deep, a little bit of a dump off to Bruce Jones, and he'll try to find some space to run before getting tripped up by Simpson.
Number 18, Bruce Jones with the reception for Langley. First down for Langley.
That'll bring up a first down for Langley as they move the chains. Spotted at the 52-yard line. Nearside hash mark. Here's a handoff to Hassan. Hassan tries to hurdle over a little bit of a traffic jam there at the line of scrimmage. Gains about 5 yards on the play. We're getting brought down by Nick Tromley of the Kodiaks.
All right, fans, we need this football back. It's a big second down here.
12 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Jones calls his cadence, takes the snap, drops back. He'll roll left, he's getting chased, tries to heave it downfield to number 12. And Gosen makes the reception as he's hauled out along the turf and hauled in that pass to pick up another first down. Jones scrambling. Looked like he was moving away from the play, but he was able to deliver a ball right there for Gosen. As a result, the Rams have a fresh set of downs. 11:30 here in the second quarter. Receivers to the near side for the Rams. Another handoff here. Hassan slips past that first initial wave. Gets wrapped up though.
Second and eight.
And bring up
for Rams.
Second down.
Correction. Second and seven for Langley.
Second and seven.
Let's make some noise for our defense once again for short. I know you two are all lined up.
Jones takes the snap. He's looking left, looking for the sideline, and that'll be a completion there, enough for the first down. He completes it once again to Gosen.
Number 12, Ryan Gosen on the reception. First down, Langley.
Snap, looks for a screenplay to Terrell Jones, and Jones gains a few yards on that one. It'll be a gain of about 5 yards.
Short, 1 yard for Wendy.
Correction will be second and short. Looks like they just need to get 1 yard for a second down. Jones in the shotgun. Hassan standing to his left side. Three receivers to the far side of the field. The receivers motioning the line. Here's Jones. He'll dump it over the middle. Number 81, Isaiah Edwards. Edwards still with room to run before getting brought down by number 22. That's Carson Flint. That'll pick up a first down. It'll give the Rams first and goal from the 5 yard line. Pistol. Three receivers to the near side. Ball firing the far hash mark. He'll hand it off to Hassan. Hassan up the middle, plunging forward, trying to get in. And it looks like the Prince George Kodiaks force another turnover as number 34, Ryan Nagel, comes away from the scrum with the ball. Kodiak's offense back out on the field. This defense standing tall, are refusing to let up, and they come up with another turnover there. As the Rams look like they were in scoring position. Instead, the Kodiaks take over on offense. Ball spotted at the 3 yard line. Cale Cowley looking to hand it off. Will try to pass it, and that will fall incomplete. Looked like it was initially a designed run play, but miscommunication between Cale Cowley and Xander Shane in the backfield. Shane went one way. Cowley opened up to the opposite. Instead, Cowley having to throw the ball away to avoid a safety. Will bring up second and 10. 40 on the clock here in the second quarter. Kodiaks come out of the huddle. Three receivers set to the near side. Pistol formation. Cale Calley takes the snap, looks to the left, looks over the middle, trying to connect to Jerome Erickson. Now that was a bit of a quick pass there. Erickson, not enough time to have gotten past that initial line of linebackers. Then the ball skips off the turf. Will bring up third down. Pinned deep in their end zone as Matt Stackhouse will concede a 2-point
safety. Surrendered by the
will give the Rams 11-0 lead. With that, we'll take a moment. We'll step away. More Kodiaks football coming up. Welcome back. Just as the Langley Rams were about ready to take their offensive series after the conceded safety by Matt Stackhouse on the third down play, the Kodiaks pinned deep against their own end zone. The Langley Rams end up calling a quick timeout that just better organized themselves offensively. Terrell Jones now, my apologies, not Terrell Jones, Trey Jones. A lot of Jones on the Langley Rams roster, but Trey Jones back to the huddle, will break the huddle as the Rams look to line themselves up. Two backs in the backfield, number 34 in as fullback. Jones will hand it off to Hassan. Hassan plunges forward, lowers the shoulder, and gains a few yards on that one.
Cairo Hassan with the carry for the Rams. It is second down for Langley.
And that means we'll bring up
second and seven.
3 yard gain there by Hassan. Split back formation. Trey Jones, three receivers to the far side. He'll drop back. He'll scan, looking deep, looking for Gosin, and that gets deflected. Shannon Donovan coming up with the pass knockdown, as it looked like Ryan Gosin was wide open. And that will bring up third down for the Rams. Here, but a wobbler as it went right off the side of the foot. A shanked punt there by the Rams, and that'll give the Kodiaks field position starting this drive from what will be their own 54-yard line. Break the huddle, three receivers to the far side of the field. There's a handoff here. Omar Martin breaks through, slips past, stays up on his feet, and picks up and up for a Kodiaks first down. off the handoff, bobbed and weaved that initial wave and came up with just enough for a first down. As the Kodiaks find themselves now inside Langley Rams' end of the field. Dale Cowley. Another mishap there in the backfield as Cowley tries to take it for himself. Miscommunication once again between Cowley and his backfield. Of about 2 yards on the play. Second and 12 with 6:04 up on the clock. Cowley lining up in the pistol. Going deep is Cowley. He's got Lewis. And that falls incomplete. Looked like it was a few yards past the outstretched arms of Lewis. But also is incoming number 23 of the Rams. Dennis Moses. Incomplete pass brings up third down. As punting comes back in on the field for Beecher. Ryan Bosa looking to return this one. He's on right around the Prince George or his own 10-yard line, rather. High snap here. Stackhouse able to get the ball away. It'll bounce at the 25 and skips out. Will bounce forward and skips out about the 33-yard line. Rams taking over on offense. Five, 33-yard line, Rashad Hatchmark, three receivers to the far side. Here's Jones, takes the snap. Looking over the middle, looking deep, looking for number two, Terrell Jones, and he somehow comes up with the ball, but it ends up landing out of bounds, and it will come as an incomplete pass. Terrell Jones showing his athleticism and his ability to climb the ladder. Unfortunately, was unable to keep his even just 1 foot in bounds. Second and 10. Pressure coming on the near side. Jones opts to pack it away. He'll still try to pass it, and he'll connect to Terrell Jones. And Jones gets wrapped up by Aiden Simpson. But not before he picks up enough for the first down. For the Rams, Jones takes the snap. They'll settle in the pocket. He'll heave it to the far side. Connect to number eight. Enough for a first down. That's Gideon Kremler. Kremler gets enough for the first down as the chains continue to move. 4:18 remaining here in the second quarter. Rams leading 11-0 over the Kodiaks as the Rams move themselves inside Prince George territory.
Timeout
being called by Prince George. We'll take a moment, have a quick break. We'll be right back.
You got to pump it up, don't you know, pump it up.
welcome back to Massage Place Stadium in the city of Prince George, also known as the Northern Capital. Thank you for those who are tuning in, whether that be on 99.3 Rewind Radio or catching the live stream on bcfctv.com. Or if you happen to be a TELUS cable subscriber on cable channel 1981. The Langley Rams currently leading the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 11-0. The Rams moving the ball here on offense with the ball being spotted inside the Prince George end of the field on the 40-yard line as Trey Jones will take the snap. He'll look to hand it off to Hassan. Hassan gets wrapped up by Nick Tremblay but continues to plunge forward for a few extra yards. And he'll gain about 8 on the play. Second down. Jones drops back, looking left, looking for the end zone. Goes in, and that falls incomplete. Another pass breakup by Aiden Simpson. It looks like Ryan Goson is favoring lower body injury here as he down on his knees currently on the 2-yard line. The medical staff will come out to tend to him. We'll take a moment, step away. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. On the play. Jones drops back, looks for the sideline, and that'll be a completion made there by number 8. That's Gideon Prebler once again. And that'll move the chains. Prebler finding himself with some space to work with, and Trey Jones capitalizing on that to get the first down here. Rams now with the ball at the 24-yard line. Fresh set it out. Jones gets to hand it off. Hassan up the middle, gets wrapped up, brought down by number 74, Weston Shields.
Cairo Hassan with the carry for the Rams.
And now a member of the Kodiaks down on the field. Sure who it may be. It will be Shields, the player who actually made the play on that previous tackle. He'll be able to pop right back up and make his way to the sideline under his own weight. The second, it looks to be about 7 yards from my vantage point. 2:51 remaining here in the second quarter. Rams moving the ball here inside the Prince George end of the field. Pistol formation, three receivers to the near side. Jones makes the snap, drops back, looks to pass, scanning the defense. He'll whip it to the left side. Isaiah Edwards wide open and a touchdown. But a flag in the backfield, and it's going against the Rams. See whether that gets called back. Penalty going against Langley.
The
what the penalty was. I think it may have been unsportsmanlike. I'll wait to see what the official call is. He'll go against the Rams.
Rams. It is now 17-0
Verlander. Result in a touchdown. The penalty will be applied on the kickoff as the Rams look to go for the convert. And that will go up between the uprights and good to give the Rams an 18-0 lead over the Prince George Kodiaks. The Kodiaks already looking to get their kickoff return team out on the field as the Langley Rams line up to kick this ball away. 18-0, 2:35 remaining here in the second quarter. Aiden Simpson and Taman Pittock back to return for PG. Ball getting moved all the way back to the 30-yard line due to that penalty on the scoring play by the Rams. It'll be number 88 kicking this ball away. Tyson Burgo. Getting kicked away, and it'll land in the hands of Aiden Simpson. And Simpson will look to make the return to find his way through the initial wall and moves it inside Langley's end of the field. And the return getting down to what looks like it's getting marked at the 46-yard line inside the Rams' end. 2:27 to work with here for this Kodiaks offense. Haven't necessarily been able to move the ball consistently here. Much of this game has been dominated by the defensive side. Galley drops back, some pressure coming. He'll connect to Jerome Erickson. Erickson trying to lean forward. And a suplex, you could say, coming.
Number 13, Jerome Erickson with the catch.
Number 19, Dawson Moore. And he flipped the Kodiaks receiver. Well, with the completion, it'll gain about 5 yards on the play. We'll bring up second down. And a minute 55 to work with. Clock rolling. Cowley takes the snap. He'll hand off Omar Martin. Martin wrapped up from behind. Number 44 with the tackle. Evan Noley. Evan Noley being one of the top players on this defensive unit. Comes into tonight with 19 tackles. Actually leads the Rams with 4 quarterback sacks on the season. Third down, Kodiaks offense staying out onto the field. And flags being thrown here as it looked like the Rams stepped offside. Number 6 of the Rams, Aaron Linden. It's a little too premature in his rush. Moves the ball. Still third down. However, it is just 1 yard now that the Kodiaks need to get in order to pick up the first down. And Cale Kelly takes the snap, tries to plunge forward. He'll get the yardage required and then some. And he'll move the chains. First down for the Kodiaks. Ball spotted at the 33-yard line. Just inside the near side hash mark. Callie takes the snap. Some pressure coming from the backside, looking for Erickson, and that will fall incomplete. Erickson battling with Kyle Hoisch of the Rams. It'll come up incomplete, and will bring up second and 10. As we're now inside the final minute of the second quarter. Kodiaks trying to find themselves on the board before halftime. Kelly drops back to pass, tries to connect to Caden Wagner coming over the middle, but that will fall incomplete. Ball thrown short. Wagner trying to hit the deck to try to reel that one in. Bring up third down. On comes Brady Harper. Brady Harper, the kicker for the Kodiaks. It'll be a 40-yard field goal attempt. Ball goes up and is good. Brady Harper remains perfect on the year with a 40-yard field goal to get the Kodiaks up on the board. And that will draw a roar from the crowd. Beautiful kick there by Brady Harper, the product of Fort McMurray, Alberta. 48.9 seconds on the board. Kodiaks will line up to kick this ball away now to the Rams. Rams leading 18-3. As Brady Harper will set this ball up to boot it away to the Rams. See whether Kodiaks trying to go for an onside kick here with 48.9 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. And it looked like there may have been some hesitation as like Brady Harper was waiting for the play to get whistled in. At that point, by the time he had already placed it, it had already been ready to go and the clock was rolling. So the ball now gets moved back from the 45 to the 35-yard line. Brady Harper will boot this one. Line drives it. And here's the Rams now trying to make a return, wrapping them up and pulling them back. And flags being thrown here. Ball popped out, number 42 of the Kodiaks. Garrett Buchik pounced on it, but it looked like the play was already over. Face mask being called against the Kodiaks.
Yes, we have a face mask penalty called on Prince George on the return. As a 15-yard penalty, it'll be first down Langley.
Go 42 seconds remaining here in the half. Langley Rams with the penalty will already be inside the Prince George end of the field. Trey Jones, line up in the shotgun. No drop back, look for a quick hit. Terrell Jones trying to weave his way in past Aiden Simpson, but Simpson comes up with a tackle, a flag being thrown on the play.
Number two, Terrell Jones, another reception for Langley. We have another penalty on the play.
Looks like it's going against the Rams. An illegal block on the play. So that'll move the Rams back. Ball gets spotted at the 55-yard line. 36.8 seconds remaining. First and 20. Jones in the pistol. He'll take the snap. He'll hand it off to Hassan. Hassan gets tripped up and brought down. Number 47 coming up with the trip there. Levi Martin, product of Prince George, former College Heights Cougar. Comes up and makes the defensive play there for Prince George. The second down and long. Jones takes the snap, he'll hand it off to Hassan, gets wrapped up, brought down. And a flag being thrown here following the play. As the clock stops at 13.3 seconds. See what the call is. And it looks like it's going against Prince George.
We have an unnecessary roughness.
Unnecessary roughness being the ball going against Prince George. We'll move the ball to the 33-yard line. It will be a first down for the Rams. There's 12.9 seconds remaining. Jones takes the snap. He'll likely look for the end zone. He does, looking for Jones, and that will fall incomplete. Jones crawling out trying to make that catch. Skips off his hand and falls incomplete with 7.6 seconds remaining. Jones gets the call from his offensive coordinator. I say offensive coordinator, but actually the one calling the shots offensively is head coach Jordan McCarty. Jones takes the snap, some pressure, some heat, and he'll dump it off to Gosen. Gosen gets wrapped up and brought down by Jules Trench on that play. The pressure was coming on Jones, and he tried to dump it off. But that play with the tackle will bring us to the end of the first half with the Langley Rams leading the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 18-3. We've got the Kodiaks halftime show coming up after this. He's fine. Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium, where we're about ready to get this second half underway between the Prince George Kodiaks and the visiting Langley Rams. The Rams leading 18-3 after the first half, a pair of touchdowns and two conceded safeties. Meanwhile, the Prince George Kodiaks able to muster a 40-yard field goal by way of Brady Harper. Harper gets the ball up on the tee and is about ready to kick this ball away to get this half started. And here we go, going for the onside to start the half. The ball's loose. Taven Pinnock picks up the loose ball, and Prince George comes up with the onside kick. Bouncing ball, Coulter Cannon playing a key role in that one as he leaped up and collided with a member of the Langley Rams. David Pittock then bounced on the ball to get his offense out on the field here in the start of the second half. Dale Galley drops back to pass. Looks, decides to roll, he'll keep it himself, and he'll go into contact and pick up enough for the first down. Now at the what looks to be, I believe, the 36-yard line inside the Langley end of the field. Hand off here, Omar Martin finds a hole. He breaks free, keeps going, is up, and it gets brought down inside the 20. Omar Martin getting this crowd up on their feet. To Omar Martin with the Langley Rams stack the deck and bring him down.
Number seven, Omar Martin with the carry once again. It is second down, Prince George.
We'll bring up second down, and it looks to be about 12. Sorry, second and 11 here for Prince George. Galley rolls right, looks for the end zone. They'll connect to Zane Kasigwa, and he'll get forced out of bounds about the 2-yard line. Offensively. 12 50 up on the clock. And Hayden Wagner gets the catch. It looked like it was close. We'll wait to see what the official rule was as he made the reception, cross the line, but then the ball popped out. We'll wait for the official ruling here from the officials. Still meet, and it is a touchdown for the Kodiaks, Hayden Wagner, with the quick, quick play right off the snap as Cale Daly connects with the top receiver for Prince George, and the Kodiaks get themselves in the end zone. For the convert after the touchdown here. That is good. Prince George Kodiaks make this a 1-4 game as the Rams lead 18-10. Flag being thrown after the play. We'll take a moment to wait to see what this call is from the officials as the Kodiaks get this crowd back into this one with a scoring drive to start the second half. Penalty happening during the convert. The convert will be good and is going against the Rams. As a result, the Kodiaks will get to kick this ball away from the Langley 50-yard line. A 15-yard penalty going against the Rams. As a result, Brady Harper kicking this ball from the Langley 50 with both returners locked on the goal line. Coulter Cannon getting some direction from head coach Jamie Borum, and he'll run that over to Brady Harper, and here's Brady Harper now, and he'll low kick drive that down and he'll skip off the turf. Here's number 84 trying to come up with a big return. He gets caught from behind and brought down to the turf by number 24, Louis Villeman. Langley Rams offense out on the field, 12:32 here in the third quarter. And they'll come out with a quads left formation here. Four receivers to the near side. Jones takes the snap, looks to go for the flat. And he'll complete it, but quickly gets met by the defense of the Kodiaks, number 84 of the Rams, looking for a quick substitution. We're following that play. That's Neil Fidesi. Rams break the huddle, line up and trips right. Three receivers to the far side, one back in the backfield to the right of Jones, and he'll hand it off to him. Here's Jones. Bruce Jones breaking the tackle. Gets tripped up by Aiden Simpson. And looks like he might be a few inches short of the first down. It'll be third down.
That's a third down.
Despite the Langley Rams sideline, indicating it's a first down. It'll be a third down for the Rams. Officials might be indicating to get a measurement here as they'll bring out the yardsticks. Rams sideline. Putting up enough of an argument to get the officials to take a second look. The positioning of the ball to the yard markers. It looks like it will be third and inches. ...11:14 remaining here in the third quarter. Kodiaks with a touchdown from Cale Talley. The new quarterback for the Prince George Kodiaks connecting with Caden Wagner on a quick hit play right off the snap, immediately delivering that pass to his inside slot receiver. He then plunged across the goal line for the score. Score now 18-10 in favor of the Rams as the Rams line up for a short yardage play. Well, my apologies, lining up for a punt here. We'll wait to see where they decide to go for a short yardage play here, but instead they'll go for the long snap, punch this ball away, and Aiden Simpson will wait to return this one. He'll make the return, tries to hit the sideline, gets wrapped up by a pair of Langley Rams. And the Kodiaks offense will come there seems to be some confusion here on the field. Looks like the Langley Rams coaching staff discussing things with the officials. Playing third down.
Fans, there was an inadvertent whistle on that last kick.
Being announced by the PA announcer here at Massive Play Stadium, an inadvertent whistle during that last play. So we'll replay third down. Ball gets snapped, gets kicked. Aiden Simpson will look to catch this off for single bounce, and a flag here. And a late flag coming the other direction. As it looks like number 28 for the Rams, Malcolm Cameron, indicating that it will be a first down for the Rams given the penalty. Whether that's how the rules work, as I believe it will be initially a no yards penalty going against Langley and then an unnecessary roughness penalty going against Prince George. Prince George Kodiaks offense out on the field.� ball getting moved back.
The penalty on the play is an unnecessary roughness called on the quick short Kodiaks.
That's a 15-yard penalty from the sponsor line inside the Prince George end of the field. His way back to the huddle. Kodiaks come to the line, lined up in a trips right formation. Three receivers to the near side. Omar Martin, the lone back in the backfield, lining up in behind Cale Galley. Galley drops back, looks to pass. He'll roll left. Trying to create some time. He'll trip up, loses his footing, and that will be an easy play for the Langley Rams defense to make as Galley tripped over, looked like he tripped over his own feet, trying to roll out and settle. The second and 15. Drops back, looks to pass, and nearly intercepted. Sean Cullen right in his mitts and let it slip. It would have been great field position had he been able to hold on to it and allow his offense back out on the field. There was a flag on the play as well. Looks like it's going against Langley. Looks like it may have been past interference, the penalty. So they'll get the ball moved up 10 yards. It'll be second and 6.
We have a 10-yard penalty on the Langley Rams. It'll be second down for the Kodiaks.
Kodiaks lining up, trips right, near side. Galley rolls, looks to hit, and he throws the completion, but then quick contact there on number 15, pop that ball loose. So, sorry, it wasn't necessarily a completion, hit the target, but that immediate contact from the defender popped the ball free for number 15, Zane Casibua, was able to take any steps and fully secure that ball. As a result, we'll bring up third down. Matt Stackhouse takes the snap. We'll boot this one away. And Ryan Gosen will let this one bounce. And he gets wrapped up by the Kodiaks coverage. Member of the Langley Rams down on the field in what would have been the Prince George backfield.
All right, friends,
four.
We need to bring some energy
Sean
back into this stadium right now.
The one that nearly came up with an interception on that previous offensive drive for the Kodiaks. Langley, pushed down. Ball being spotted at the 46-yard line. Far side hash mark. And Trey Jones and the offense line up with a trick left. Ryan Gosen coming in motion. Four receivers to the near side. Hands off. Tyrell Hassan up the middle, tries to shake free, and the Kodiaks wrap him up. It'll be a gain of a few yards.
Nicholas Trampley. Second down for Langley.
Gain of about 3 yards, 4 yards on that play. Brings up second and 6. He'll drop back, looks to pass, scanning over the middle, looks to heave it. That goes in, that actually a completed pass to Terrell Jones. That went through a series of leaping hands of the Kodiak's defense and found its way into the hands of number two in white.
The result of the play is a first down for Langley.
The snap, hands it off, Cairo Hassan, he'll go off tackle, he'll avoid a pair of tackles and slips it into the secondary before getting brought down by number 36, Colter Penn. He'll pick up the first down with that run. And he'll move the chains. First down being spotted at the 26-yard line inside of the big turn down the field. He'll whip it over to Terrell Jones. Along the sideline, I'll pick up a few yards. Pick up
that tackle by number 25, Peyton Briere.
Six yards on the play.
It's second down for Langley.
And second and four.
We need a hold here, folks. Let's make some more
yards. Rams break the huddle, line up with a trip set to the right side, far side of the field. Rolled back, Cairo Hassan to the left is Trey Jones. Jones drops back, heaves it into the end zone, and nearly picked off Aiden Simpson. And folks, that's why he's a DB and not a wide receiver. Nearly comes up with an interception, but strong coverage there from graduating players for Prince George in Aiden Simpson.
It looks like they're going for it. We need to get a stop here.
Try to shake that one off. That aside, Aiden Simpson having a strong performance here against the Rams. Rams looking to go for it. Jones drops back, looks for the end zone. And that will fall incomplete. Isaiah Edwards, the intended target. It flew about 5 to 7 yards past Edwards on that pass. 6:25 remaining here in the third quarter. Kodiak's offense, a turnover on down, so Kodiak's offense will take over. Kodiak's find themselves down by 8. Takes the snap, he'll hand it off. Omar Martin tries to weave his way through that initial front. Gain maybe a yard on the
number seven, Omar Martin with the carry. Second down, pretty short.
A gain of 2 yards on the play. Bring up second and 8. Prince George. 5:52 remaining here in the third quarter. Spotted at the 22-yard line. Dowley takes the snap. He'll step up. Looks to call his own number. He'll try to weave his way through. And he'll pick up enough for the first down. And flags being thrown. Like Sean Cullen continuing to get himself in the mix of things is like he actually been the one drawing the penalty against himself, I would say. Like he's in the middle of a pushing match with a few members of the Kodiak offensive line. As a result, ends up finding himself being the one having the penalty called.
First down,
offense will wait for this crowd to settle down before calling for the snap. Cowley going deep, looking for Zane Katsingawa, and that will fall incomplete. Number 15 found himself in behind coverage, was wide open, but Cale Cowley couldn't quite connect with his receiver on that play. Second and 10. Trips left for the Kodiaks. Cowley will heave it towards the near sideline, but no receiver in the vicinity. And that ball's incomplete. Bring up third down. Remaining here in the third quarter. Matt Stackhouse to punt this one away. Grounding snap, and that gets blocked by the Rams. And they'll look to return this one. Open real estate for number 27. And he'll return it for the touchdown.
We have a block punt.
No flags on the play, and Langley, back-to-back weeks, comes up with a blocked punt, returned for a touchdown. No snap, starting a series of unfortunate events on that play for Prince George.
The score is now 24-10 for the Rams.
And the Rams will line up for a point after. We're able to get a little bit of that convert, but I believe it still slips through.
Extra point is good. It is 25-10 for the Rams.
As a result, the Langley Rams now lead the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 25-10. We'll be right back with more Kodiaks football right after this. Returning that kickoff just moments ago, getting the ball up to looks to be about the 39-yard line as the Kodiaks offense will come back out onto the field following the blocked punt return for a touchdown by Langley. Make this score 25-10 here with 4:20 remaining here in the third quarter. Lining up. Three receivers to the far side of the field. Dale Callum drops back. Looks to pass. He'll roll. Tries to connect Jerome Erickson. That will fall incomplete. Bring up second and 10. To his quarterback. Kodiaks will now break the huddle, line up. Three receivers going to the far side of the field. Xander Shane motioning to the off tackle. Cale Cowley rolling left, looks to pass, tries to connect, and that will fall incomplete. Matthew Sturgis, the intended target on that play.
Third down at Kodiaks.
Instead, we'll bring up third down.
This is your last call for game day 50-50. Jackpot is sitting at $2,840. We'll be announcing over at the fourth quarter, so have your tickets ready.
Snapped a high back spinning punt here by Stackhouse, and that'll bounce out close to the 55 yard line. Looks like it's getting spotted at the Prince George 53. Take over on offense, already with the 2 yards inside the Prince George end of the field. Here's Trey Jones, will take the snap, he'll hand it off. Cairo Hassan goes right into the wall, trying to plunge forward, gets stacked up and brought down to the field.
Tackle made by number 25, Peyton
Breer. Peyton Breer, number 25, coming
second
up with the tackle on that play.
A little bit louder in here.
Breer being one of the youngest players to be playing in the CJFL this year, if not the youngest. Still in high school, currently attending Dutchess Park here in Prince George.
We have an injury timeout on the field.
They do have an injury on the field, so we'll take a moment, we'll step away, we'll be right back with more Kodiaks football right after this. Welcome back. Number 73, Jules French, the injured Kodiak on that previous play, currently walking off. Right hand, maybe a step. Able to walk off on his own. It's a good sign. Meanwhile, the Rams taking the snap, dropping back as Trey Jones, as he rolls left, he's looking to tuck it away, and he'll get forced out of bounds. Close to the first down marker. See where it's getting marked. Marked third down, so a yard and a half short of the first down marker. And short, just inches to get that first down. Langley getting out on the field. Trey Jones lining up under center. Jones will look to hand it off to Cairo Hassan. Hassan plunges forward. Initially stopped and then went for a second attempt and stretched out. And it looked like he may have gotten enough for the first down, and indeed he did. The chains will move as the Rams keep their offensive drive alive, moving the chains with that first down run. Minute 55 on the clock. Here in the third quarter, Trey Jones in the pistol. Cairo Hassan alone back in the backfield. Three receivers to the left, right side, and wrapped up in the backfield. Cairo Hassan gets wrapped and brought down by Peyton Crow, number 55 in the last. bring up second down. A lot of yards. Receivers to the near side. Rams take the snap. Here's some pressure. Jones scrambling now, getting chased down by Pratt. He needs it. And that will fly out of bounds. And that will bring up third and long. But there is a flag on the play. Like it might be going, and it is, a holding penalty going against the Rams. Kodiak will opt to decline that as it brings, will bring up third down, and the punt team comes out onto the field for the Rams. We'll wait to see whether it is the punt team. It looks like it is. Simpson hovering around his own goal line. A high snap is number 28 chasing it down, still bouncing, and he'll get chased down by the Kodiak's coverage, and it gets picked off. Nick Tremblay comes up with an interception, and it looks like the penalty is going against the Rams. An illegal forward pass going against number 28. Malcolm Cameron. Nick Tremblay coming up with the interception, but we'll wait to see whether it actually does stand. Colter Cameron meeting with the officials. Illegal forward pass will get declined. It will be a turnover.
That one's on Langley. We also have a turnover on downs.
So it will be a turnover on downs. So the interception will not stand. As the Kodiak's offense will take over from the 42-yard line. Dale Gallo takes the snap, some pressure coming over the middle, but he connects to Jerome Erickson. He has room to run. He'll cut to the sideline, still goes, and he'll step out of bounds at about the 48-yard line. Seconds here in the third quarter. The first and 10. Kelly takes the snap, looks to pass, steps up. He'll try to deliver again to Jerome Erickson, and Erickson will take a pop.
Pass incomplete. It is second down, Prince George.
That falls incomplete. And that will bring us to the end of the third quarter. We'll take a moment. We'll step away. Kodiak's moving the ball here on offense.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Prince George Kodiaks. Now getting ready to get the fourth quarter underway. Ball spotted at the 49-yard line, far side Ashmark. Phil Cowley waiting for the whistle to start the fourth quarter as the final few seconds will tick off the clock on the time between quarters. Looks like the Kodiaks will be lining up in a trips left formation. Three receivers to the near side. Xander Shane will be the lone back accompanying Dale Cowley, the quarterback. Here we go. Kale Cowley drops back, looks to pass. He'll scramble to the right side. Looks to go deep to Taman Pinnock. And Pinnock makes the reception, gets brought down towards the 15-yard line, and the chains will roll. First and 10 for Prince George. Looks like Taman Pinnock found himself in between coverage. Kale Cowley takes the snap. He'll hand it off. Xander Shane plunges forward. He'll get to the 10-yard line.
Number 18, Xander Shane on the carry. It'll be second and short for the Kodiaks.
It looks to be about 4 yards to go here. Kale Cowley in the pistol. Three receivers to the far side. One motioning over. That's Caden Wagner. Cowley rolling right. Looks for the end zone. Touchdown! Jerome Erickson! Kodiaks get themselves another to get themselves closer to biting into this deficit against the Rams as they line up for the point after. And Brady Harper splits the uprights. Score now 25-17. We'll take a moment, we'll step away, we'll be right back with more fourth quarter action. Brady Harper booting this ball away on the kickoff back to the Langley Rams as the Rams try to return this one following the touchdown drive that saw Jerome Erickson earning himself his second touchdown of the season to get the Kodiaks within one score. Rams leading 25-17. Kodiaks will need to get a touchdown and a two-point combo to tie the game. 13:35 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Langley Rams offense back out on the field. Three receivers to the near side. Trey Jones drops back, looks to pass, goes for the far sideline. That gets completed. And it looks like number 8 slips past coverage. Number 8 Gideon Kremler. That's his third or fourth reception of the night. And he'll come up with a few yaks on that one, yards after the catch. After he's able to slip away from contact. Looks like two Kodiak defenders were draped on his jersey. First and 10 for the Rams. Ball spotted, 52-yard line. Trey Jones takes the snap. He'll hand it off. He'll keep it, actually. Trey Jones finds a way up the gut, and he'll get enough yards for the first down. And that'll move the chains once again.
Number 11, Trey Jones, on the PD run for Langley. That's good for a first down for the Rams.
On the 45-yard line in between the hash marks. Three receivers to the far side of the field, two to the near side. With one running back standing to the left of Trey Jones. He'll hand it off. Here's Bruce Jones trying to find a way. He'll get wrapped up and forced to the sideline. Gain of 2 yards on that play. Bring up second and what looks to be about 8 yards for the Rams. Three receivers going to the far side of the field. 11:45 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Trey Jones takes the snap, looks to pass over the middle. Wide open is Kremler, and he'll make the reception. That's Isaiah Edwards with the reception. That comes up with a first down play. Slipped in past the coverage. Gets the ball down to the 16-yard line. Jones, play action here, is looking left. He'll step back up into the pocket. He'll roll right, trying to come up with some yardage on his own. And he'll gain about 5 yards on the play. Looks like there's an injured Ram down on the field. We'll take a moment, we'll step away, take a quick break. We'll be right back.
We have an injured player on the field, folks.
Isaiah Edwards, the injured Ram on the previous play, he's now on the sideline. Trey Jones takes the snap, looks to hand it off. Up the gut, Bruce Jones makes a few moves and gets in the end zone for a touchdown. As the Rams move their total up to 31.
Fans, the winner of the 50-50 draw for tonight's game is ticket number B1208. Once again, that's B-1208. You are the winner
Jones
of
coming up with the touchdown scamper.
Once
that's
again,
his second
B-1208.
Major of the season.
Please come to the announcer booth at the top
Rams
of the stand.
Rams line up for a point after. Don't get it's snapped and that goes up and through. Make it 32-17 in favor of Langley. Both sides will line themselves up and look to kick this ball away to the Kodiaks.
The winner of tonight's winning draw, winning ticket is B-1208. Company announcers going to collect your prize.
And I believe that's Michael Olea. Back to return. Or actually, no, that's number 31. That's Micaiah Williams for Prince George, the two returners. And here we go. As the ball gets kicked away, Micaiah Williams will make the return. And Williams will try to find, use his speed to get to the sideline, make a few moves, and he'll get tackled, brought down to shy of the 30-yard line.
Williams on the return. First down, Prince George.
Kodiak's offense back out on the field, 10:30 remaining on the clock. Come out of the huddle, three receivers to the far side. Xander Shane alone back in the backfield. Some motion here. Cale Calley drops, rolls, looks for the lead. That's Caden Wagner, and that'll be a completion. Caden Wagner picks up a few yards. Maybe four on the play.
Second down, Prince George.
Bring up second and six. Kodiak's three receivers to the near side. Cale Calley drops back. Try to connect. Jerome Erickson draped all over. And no flag on the play. Looked like Dawson Warren was all over Jerome Erickson before the ball was even delivered, but no flags being thrown will bring up third down for Prince George. .920 up on the clock. Ball gets snapped, gets kicked. Stackhouse gets this one away. He'll skip off the 45-yard line and making its way to Ryan Gosen. Gosen trying to direct his blocks, making his way to the near sideline. He's got room and nothing but all in front of him as he taunts Coulter Cannon as he makes his way into the end zone. To their lead, but there is a flag on the play. We'll see whether it gets called back. Two flags, actually, three. Counting all the laundry on the turf here at Massage Place Stadium. As it looks like the punt return will not stand. Great to see him have all of this sorted out. So penalties going against Langley. Will be a first down for the Rams as they take over on offense. However, see what the penalties are. The Rams will take over on offense from the 46 yard line.
We also have a penalty charge for the Prince George Kodiaks on the return for unsportsmanlike conduct.
8:57 remaining here in the fourth quarter.
The result is first down line.
Four receivers to the near side, just one on the weak side to the far side of the field. Here's Trey Jones. He'll hand it off. Bruce Jones trying to find a hole. He does. Stays up on his feet. Gets brought down by Jason Pratt. Close to the first down. Yeah, it looks like he will have been just 1 yard past that first down marker, so that'll move the chain.
First down.
Harold Jones, just the lone receiver to the near side, hands it off to Bruce Jones. And he gets wrapped up and brought down after a gain of about 5 or 6 yards on the play.
Tackle by number 27, Nicholas Tremblay.
Nick Tremblay on the tackle on that previous play. Second and four. Rams going four receivers to the near side once again. Trey Jones hands it off. Bruce Jones with the run. He'll get wrapped up. Looks like the Rams just trying to wear down this defense on the ground. They'll pick up a first down and move the chains. First down from the 44-yard line. Trey Jones, three receivers to the near side. He'll hand it off. Bruce Jones right up the gut. And Jason Pratt gets his mitts in there to bring Jones back.
There's a big stop again by
that'll
big number 90.
That'll be a stop there. That'll bring up second down. Gain of about 3 yards on the play. 6:30 remaining in the fourth quarter. Rams leading by a score of 32-17. Jones takes the snap, he'll drop back, there's some rush, and he'll dump it off to Jones. He's got room to run, he'll cut over, and looks to get all the way down and into the end zone as he breaks tackles and scores a touchdown here for the Rams. A flag being thrown, though,
in the end zone. That is a touchdown for number 18, Bruce Jones of the Lady Rams.
To see what the flag is. Wonder whether it's perhaps going against the Rams with their celebration in the end zone. We'll wait to see from the officials. It will be a touchdown. So Bruce Jones gets his second score of the night. One on the ground, one through the air. And the Langley Rams lining up for a convert here.
Extra point is good. It is
the Rams make it 39-17. 6:03 remaining in the fourth quarter. We'll take a moment, we'll step away, and we'll be right back after this. Do one commercial and then the moment. I think first but surely finish last. Welcome back. The Langley Rams kicking this ball away to the Kodiaks after they just made it 39-17. Micaiah Williams. And a late hit here going against the Rams. Micaiah Williams down on the ground trying to recover the ball. And in came flying. I believe it's number 6, Aaron Linden. Completely leveled and already on the ground, Micaiah Williams, and that will draw flags. Unnecessary ruckus, but even the call. Move the ball later up for the Kodiaks as Prince Forrest takes over on offense. The ball on the 47-yard line. 5:50 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Dale Galley takes the snap, he'll drop back, looks to pass, goes deep. He's looking for Brady Van Summeren, and that will fall incomplete. Or will it? Is it picked off? A flag on the play. Still waiting for indication from the officials. May have been Damon Pennick being taken to target on that one. Not Brady Van Summeren, but it does look like it will be a turnover as the Rams offense comes back out onto the field.
We have a possible here called on the offense for George Kodiaks.
That's the one you're applying. Pass interference going against the Kodiaks. Interception on the play, giving the Rams the ball with 5:40 here in the fourth quarter. Play here completed here to Ryan Gosen. Gosen gets wrapped up, brought down by Jason Pratt. Pratt just being an absolute workhorse here on this defense here tonight. Wouldn't be surprised if he's up to double digits now on tackles. Five minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Rams first and 10 from the 40. Change here at quarterback. And Bruce Jones gets wrapped up and brought down. Number 7, Maxwell Gruden at quarterback for the Rams. Saw him in action last week through a pair of touchdowns after taking over for Trey Jones. Ball on the 41-yard line. Three receivers to the far side, two to the near side, just one back in the backfield. Here's Boogie, he'll drop back, looks over the middle, and that goes incomplete. Number 81, the intended target. Isaiah Anderson. A target on that one will bring up third down. Aiden Simpson back to return this one. He'll hover around the 25-yard line. Ball gets snapped. Here comes pressure. Ball gets booted away. Aiden Simpson makes the return. He'll try to find a lane, and he'll get wrapped up just shy of the 45-yard line.
Number 3, Aiden Simpson on the return. First down, Kodiaks.
Big knife, big knife, big knife, big knife, big knife.
offense. We'll take over. Ball on the 44-yard line. Near side hash mark. Breaks the huddle. Three receivers going to the far side. Braden Van Summering, the far side wideout. As Cowley will take the snap, rolls to his right immediately, looking for a pass. He'll throw it deep, and that will fall incomplete. Two Langley Rams in coverage on the roof. That was Matthew Sturgis, the intended target. 3:24 remaining here in the quarter. Break the huddle, Xander Shane, the lone back, as Cale Cowley lines up in the pistol. Three receivers to the near side, Cowley drops back, some pressure coming off the edge, heaves it downfield, and that will fall incomplete. But a flag here in the backfield, as number 78 of the Kodiaks, Michael Walters-Bua, gets back to his feet. Looked like he was favoring an injury of some sort. It looks like he will decide to take a knee. Flag in the Kodiaks backfield as the official moves the ball up. Looks like it will be roughing the passer, I believe.
It'll be roughing the passer called on the Langley Rams. First down, Brent
like number 44 of the Langley Rams, Evan Noley, looking to the official asking for an explanation, but it looks like the official is simply just shrugging their shoulders. And looks like the officials will gather around the ball. Ball spotted at the 51-yard line inside the Langley end of the field, and they will now disperse. Both sides awaiting the play to be whistled in. 2:57 on the clock. Two receivers to the near side for the Kodiaks. Cowley drops back to pass. Some pressure coming off the edge. Cowley will call his own number. Looks to run. Gets wrapped up, brought down, but it looks like he'll have enough for the first down. Will move the chains, I believe. And it'll be 1 yard short. So it'll bring up second and one.
Second down and short for Short.
2:30 remaining here in the game. Cowley takes snap, hands off to Xander Shane. He'll get wrapped up, brought down behind the line.
Number 18, Xander Shane on the carry. No gain on the play.
It's third down. Line of scrimmage. It'll bring up third down. Break the huddle, the lineup in a trips right formation. Three receivers to the far side. Cale Cowley calls his own number, plunges forward, and he'll get the yardage required for a first down.
Number 11, Cale Cowley on the run. It's good for a first down.
That'll move the chains. 2:01 on the clock. Snap, Cowley looking right. He'll look, he'll tuck it away himself. He'll make it for the sideline. Tries to find the edge, and he'll get another first down. I'm definitely against them, preventing them from likely making any substantial comeback, but at the same time, eventually Kodiak's piecing together some consistent offense here by way of their new signal caller, Kale Cowley. Rams leading 39-17. Kodiak's likely seeing if they can wrap the game up with another trip to the end zone. And the Langley Rams decide to call themselves a defensive timeout. Trying to tighten things up here. Meanwhile, Prince George Kodiak's offense still huddled up on the field. Ball spotted at the 29-yard line. Fresh set of downs following back-to-back runs by Cowley. One to pick up the short yardage, the other picking up a full 10 yards on the ground. Three receivers to the near side. Kale Cowley takes the snap. He'll drop, looks to pass, rolls to the left. He'll avoid the pressure. Still looking. He'll try to pass it. Tries to connect with Taman Pinnock, but that skips off the turf. And it may have just slipped out of the hand of Cowley. He'll bring up second and 10. Second and 10, Kale Cowley in the pistol. Xander Shane, the lone back in the backfield. Cowley drops back, some pressure coming from the backside. Cowley still looking, looks to pass, tries to send it to Taman Pinnock once again, but that skips off the turf as Pinnock was having to step off his route to adjust to that one. Well, there's the Langley Rams player down on the field close to the goal line. Take a moment, we'll step away, and we'll be right back after this.
Go for another one. Just go down. All right, let's come back after this one. Literally just.
Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium. The Langley Rams leading the Prince George Kodiaks 39-17 with a minute 28 remaining here in the fourth quarter. So the Rams on their way to improve their record to 4-2. Meanwhile, Prince George Kodiaks seeing if they can find themselves back in the end zone here offensively. Kale Cowley heaving it for the end zone, and that will fall incomplete. It looks like he was trying to connect with Jerome Erickson. Then that'll be a turnover on downs. A minute 21 remaining on the clock. Langley Rams, 39 points on the other side. The Kodiaks. Drastic improvement from last week's performance. A game in which they were shut out by the Langley Rams. Squeezed together 17 points here tonight. Two passing touchdowns and a field goal. Goes down as another loss on the year. Definitely improvements made by the Kodiaks this past week of practice in leading up to this game. Well, the Langley Rams offense back out onto the field. Maxwell Grigge hands it off up the gut. And that will get wrapped up for a few yards.
Tackled
by number 55, Caden Crowe.
Second down for Langley.
Second and eight. Gain of a yard or two. Inside the final minute now. That's Roy Boogie. Hand it off once again. And a trek forward. Number 31 gets wrapped up and brought down.
Number 45, Justin. By Nick Tromblay. On the tackle for Prince George. That's a third down, folks.
Gavin Shaw on the run. They bring up third down. Aiden Simpson back to return this punt, 42.6 seconds remaining on the clock. The ball gets booted away. Aiden Simpson will let it bounce once, bounce twice before catching it off the hop, and he'll get wrapped up by number 47 and tackled out of bounds.
Number 3, Aiden Simpson on the return for the Kodiaks. First down, Prince George.
Kodiaks offense now out on the field. 32.3 seconds to work with. See if they can get back into the end zone. Drops back, looks to pass over the middle. Nearly a one-handed grab by Kevin Wagner. That will fall incomplete. And the Langley Rams making it evident to the Kodiaks what the score is as they continue to point up to the scoreboard after just about every single play now. Cowley drops back, looks to pass, he'll step up into the pocket, he'll roll left, tries to connect Jerome Erickson on the sideline, he'll step out of bounds. That'll pick up a first down with 21.4 seconds on the clock.
First down, Prince George.
The chains, ball spotted at the 52-yard line, near side hash mark. And play will get whistled in. Cale Cowley in the pistol. Take the snap, drops back, looks to pass, rolls left, tries to heave it downfield, looking for Erickson, and that'll get picked off. Number 15, and he'll get tripped up by Taman Pinnock.
Interception on the
Kenneth
play.
Kenneth Galukos with the interception on the play.
The result of the play is a first down for Langley.
10.6 seconds on the clock.
Yeah.
Rams will take over, and that'll basically do it. 10.6 seconds, Rams leading 39-17 here. It looks like the Rams will still decide to try to pass the ball here, and that gets nearly picked off as the Rams, despite leading by an abundance of points, trying to continue to pick away at this defense. With 4 seconds on the clock, it looks like they'll go for one more shot. They'll hand it off. And number 31 slips off tackle and will eventually get wrapped up by Nick Tremblay and brought to the ground for as the final second kick off the clock.
The Rams, 39.
And the Rams gesturing to the crowd.
It was a good fight by Prince George, but not
showing their sportsmanship. The lack thereof, I would say, as the clock expires here at Massachusetts Stadium. The Langley Rams defeat the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 39-17. Improve their record to 4-2, while the Prince George Kodiaks see their record go to 2-4 on the year. We'll take a moment, we'll step away. We'll be right back with Kodiaks postgame show coming up after this. Like one segment break, then come back and say goodbye.